إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ولن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف عنها الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. يقول ربنا جل وعلا في محكم كتابه آمرا عباده بالتقوى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. ويقول سبحانه: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. ويقول جل وعلا: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما، الفوز بالجنة أيها الأحبة. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله جل وعلا، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، أعاذنا الله وإياكم منها، وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. ثم أما بعد، praise be to Allah Azza wa Jal, praise be only to Him. So ever Allah Azza wa Jal guided him to the right path, there is no one can cause him astray. And whosoever Allah Azza wa Jal let him go astray, there is no one can guide him to the right path. And I bear witness that there is no God be truly worshipped but Allah Azza wa Jal. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam is Allah's messenger and Allah's prophet. Allah Azza wa Jalla sended him with the last message to all kind of human, all kind of jinn, to take them out of darkness, to lightness, out of worshipping thousands of idols, to worship only Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابُ وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابُ فَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ مِمَّا فِيهِ ويقولون يا ويلتنا ما لهذا الكتاب لا يغادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصاها ووجدوا ما عملوا حاضرا ولا يظلم ربك أحدا. الله سبحانه وتعالى said in this ayah, in the day of resurrection, that book will be given to each one, to everyone, and those who denied the message from Allah Azza wa Jalla to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and those who commit sins and don't go back on these sins and don't repent from it to Allah Azza wa Jalla and insist on these sins, and those criminals, those mujrimeen, all those will get their book with the left hand in that day of resurrection. And the righteous, the muttaqeen, the people who follow what Allah Azza wa Jalla and fear Him,
So they fear him so much that they do what Allah Azza wa Jalla ordered them, and they love they stay away from everything that Allah Azza wa Jalla forbid them from doing. And they love him so much, so they do everything he ordered them to do. So they get their book with the right hand in the day of resurrection. And those mujrimeen, they know, they fear, they know what in that book. وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابِ فَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ مِمَّا فِيهِ. And what they say? وَيَقُولُونَ يَا وَيْلَتَنَا. Oh, to us. Woe to us. Woe to us about what they know, what they see in their book. From all the sins and all this denying the message from Allah Azza wa Jalla, and they never repent from it. يَا وَيْلَتَنَا. مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ لَا يُغَادِرُ صَغِيرَةً وَلَا كَبِيرَةً إِلَّا أَحْصَاهَا. That book, how come, is recording everything. Then it doesn't leave anything, minor sin or a major sin. Everything is recorded in it. لا يغادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصاها ووجدوا ما عملوا حاضرا. And they find whatever they did in their life, it is right there presented in front of them in their book. ولا يظلم ربك أحدا. Your Lord doesn't do any wrong to his creation. Doesn't punish someone without a sin or without anything he did. And it doesn't leave the one who got good deeds without rewarding him. ولا يظلم ربك أحدا. These sins that we commit in this life, and we always say, oh, it is no problem, it is a small sin. It is not a major sin. It is not a big sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive me without repenting, without asking Allah Azza wa Jalla forgiveness from that sin, just because we think it is so small, it is no problem. But look, what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لا يحرم الرزق بالذنب يصيبه. That the servant will not get his provision because of the sin that you commit. That provision is doors in the in heavens, doors in the skies up there. Open right there to give you your rizq, to give you your provision that Allah Azza wa Jalla provided you with. There is a door to give you your health, provide you with your health, and another to provide you with hidayah, with guidance to the Islamic monotheism and worshipping Allah Azza wa Jalla, only Him, and following the order from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is a provision. That is one of the best provisions that we get, that Allah Azza wa Jalla guide us to follow His order subhanahu wa ta'ala. And another door to be dutiful to your parents, birrul walidain, and also a door for your kids to be dutiful to you. And Allah Azza wa Jalla guide them and give them the guidance to follow the orders from Allah Azza wa Jalla, and one of the best to be dutiful to the parents. Many doors for the provision, one for the wealth that you have, one for the health that you have. Everything is provision from Allah Azza wa Jalla. But when we commit a sin, one of these doors will be closed. We commit another sin, another door will be closed. And another, how are we going to get the provision that Allah Azza wa Jalla gave us? As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you prevent that provision. It stays away from you because you're committing a sin. So what we do to get that? What we do to open the door again? Repentance to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah Azza wa Jalla also said in the Holy Quran, وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ لِمَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا ثُمَّ تَابَ. And I am forgiven. For who? For those who come back in repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sincere repentance, not only with the tongue, but sincere with the conditions of repentance to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So He promised to accept that repentance when we do that. وإني لغفارٌ, I am forgiven to those لمن تاب, to those who repent to Allah عز وجل. وآمن and believed in the Islamic monotheism and Allah عز وجل, and also in the reward from Allah when he repented to him سبحانه وتعالى. لمن تاب وآمن وعمل صالحا, and he proved that by acting on good righteous deeds. ثم اهتدى, then we the one who guided him to the right path. سبحانك يا رب. Look at what Allah عز وجل also said, والله يريد أن يتوب عليكم. So Allah عز وجل يريد الذين يتبعون الشهوات أن تميلوا ميلا عظيما. Allah سبحانه وتعالى, He wishes to accept your repentance. So what does that mean? Allah Azza wa Jalla wish to accept our repentance, but just come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and repent to Him, and He will accept your repentance. But just have that sincere repentance to Allah Azza wa Jalla. وَيُرِيدُ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الشَّهَوَاتِ أَنْ تَمِيلُوا مَيْلًا عَظِيمًا. And those who follow the forbidden desire, they don't want you to repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. They want you to stay away from that righteous path that Allah Azza wa Jal made for you and ordered you to follow. So stay close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in ayat al-tawbah, the verses about tawbah, subhanallah, it is so much beautiful. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look at the great ayah, the great verse that Allah azza wa jal told us in the whole Quran, that Allah revealed to His messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to tell His servant about it. Allah azza wa jal said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Tell those who committed lots of sins and they thought that Allah عز وجل will never forgive them. It's too much. I committed too much. How Allah will forgive me? So Allah عز وجل is saying, قل يا عبادي, oh my servant, that you committed lots of sins, don't despair of the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. Allah Azza wa Jalla forgive all sins. Look at the word, this doesn't forgive one and believe one. No, just come with the repentance and Allah Azza wa Jalla forgive all the sins. إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Verily Allah Azza wa Jal is the often forgiven, most merciful سبحانه عز وجل. So we just come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the repentance. Any sin that we do, don't think it is small, it is or big, is it minor or major, just come back to Allah Azza wa Jal and ask His repentance, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise to forgive us. And one more thing that we have to put in our mind. Don't think that because you pray, you fast, you do everything, you try to do everything that Allah Azza wa Jal ordered you to do. Don't think that after you commit that sin, you will never come back to sins again. That is what you have to put in your mind and your heart when you make repentance. The sincere repentance that I will never come back to sin in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jal, or to myself or to anyone. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us sinful. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that كل ابن آدم خطأ وخير الخطائين التوابون. All the children of Adam, they are sinners. But the best of them, those who come back to Allah Azza wa Jal in a sincere repentance and ask forgiveness from Him, and Allah Azza wa Jal promised to forgive them. So that means that yes, we're going to commit sins again. We'll go back to Allah Azza wa Jal and ask forgiveness again and repent to Him. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَلَا يَمَلَّ اللَّهُ حَتَّى تَمَلُّ. Allah Azza wa Jalla will never give up on us unless we give up our dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and unless we don't repent to Him and ask His forgiveness. As long as we do, as long as Allah Azza wa Jalla will forgive us. That is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said when the man came to him and asked him, I committed a sin. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is written. So he said, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness and I repent. He said, Allah Azza wa Jal will accept your repentance and forgive you. He said, and I commit a sin again. He said, it's written against you. He said, and I repent. So he said, Allah will forgive you. And each time he said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says the same thing up till the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَلَا يَمَلَّ اللَّهُ حَتَّى تَمَلُّ. Always come back to Allah Azza wa Jal, because He will never give up on you, up till you give up your dua. So always make the dua. May Allah Azza wa Jal forgive us. If there is anything we commit, go back straight. And I want to mention just one thing that I hear the complaint from some of the brothers about the sisters, is that when they come to the masjid, they come uncovered, and after that they cover themselves in the masjid. And when they go out, they just take the cover again. Some that we talk to, why you don't wear the hijab? She say, oh, it's too hot, I can't take it. What about the heat of Jahannam? What about the sun only? In the day of judgment, the resurrection, it is like 50,000 years of the days that we count now. We're going to be standing right there. Who is going to be away from that sun, from that heat? The seven kinds. سَبْعَةٌ يُظُلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظُلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, only seven kinds of people, they will be in the shade of Allah Azza wa Jal away from that heat of the sun. So what I mean, follow the order of Allah Azza wa Jal. Some they say, we are in America, we can't do that. Oh, I am working, I can't put my hijab. All this is excuses that you're taking order from the creation and leaving the one who creates the creator order, subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, take, لا طاعة لمخلوق في معصية الخالق. You can't obey any of the creator and disobey the creator Azza wa Jal. And don't forget that you are responsible. كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. All of us, we're going to be questioned of the day of resurrection about our responsibility. We are responsible, and we're going to be asked about this responsibility before Allah Azza wa Jal in the day of resurrection. So the man, irresponsible, he's responsible for his family, his wife, his kids, everybody that he have a hand on. And there's a woman also responsible for her kids, for her home, everything. She has to follow the order of Allah Azza wa Jalla too. So as the man have to follow the order, and don't be wrong to anyone that Allah Azza wa Jalla give you responsibilities and give them the right, also the woman. And the number one right, the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the right of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the right of the new responsibility that Allah Azza wa Jalla gave you. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه. Dear brothers and sisters, look at
at this ayat, how we heard about tawbah, about repentance, about sincere repentance, and how Allah Azza wa Jal accept. There is also one ayat. You hear about it, you think about what Allah Azza wa Jal said in this ayat, and it is really, if we know that, what Allah Azza wa Jal gives for this repentance, how we cannot do it? How we cannot go back right away to Allah Azza wa Jal with sincere repentance to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the description of those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them Ibadur Rahman. Ibadur Rahman. The servant of the most beneficent, Allah Azza wa Jal. Ibadur Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them that they don't commit those major sins. And after that, in the end of this ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَٰلِكَ يَلْقَ أَثَامًا. And whoever commit this kind of sins, he will get that punishment. يَلْقَ أَثَامًا. يُضَاعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَيَخْلُدْ فِيهِ مُهَانًا. In the day of resurrection, he will be getting double the torment in that day of resurrection. And he will be in Jahannam for eternity, humiliated. But after that, after this, Allah Azza wa Jal made exception. إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. Except those who came back with sincere repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they believed in the reward from Allah Azza wa Jalla for their repentance, and they believed in the Islamic monotheism. إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. Not only forgive them, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change this sins. These major sins will be changed to good deeds. The servant, the man, will be looking at his book in the day of judgment, and he will find these good deeds in his book, and he will wonder from where it came, these good deeds. And Allah Azza wa Jalla laugh of his servant at that day, and he will be told, that is the major sins that you committed and made a sincere repentance from it, and Allah Azza wa Jalla changed it for you to hasanat. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he narrated that hadith, he also laughed, and he said, Allah Azza wa Jalla laughed from his servant when he was wondering, from where is this hasanat in the day of resurrection? May Allah Azza wa Jalla make us one of those who get this kind of hasanat. I just want to remind you with one more thing in this time now. This is the time of Hajj is coming very soon. And the Hajj is the fifth pillar of Islam. Without performing your Hajj, the fifth pillar, your Islam is not completed as long you have the ability to perform the Hajj. What is the ability? As Allah Azza wa Jal said in the Holy Quran. So it is obligated, that Hajj to who? To the one man istafa'a ilayhi sabila. Who is that? The one who have the help and have the will to go to perform that Hajj. We don't know what is going to happen to us tomorrow. Maybe you cannot get out of the door. Who knows? Maybe you cannot put the foot in front of the other. We don't know our ajal, when is going to be. And we're going to leave everything behind us. We're going to leave our work, our wealth, our children, our wives, everything. We're not going to take anything with us in our grave. Nothing in the coffin. It doesn't have pockets. So if Allah Azza wa Jalla, for those who didn't perform Hajj and they have the ability to do it, you still have the time this year. Now, there is many agencies. They still have rooms to make the reservation. So if Allah Azza wa Jalla gave you the means to do it, to perform it, and you didn't yet, Go ahead and do it today. Don't wait for next year.
How many people they were with us last year for Hajj time, and they never performed Hajj, and they are not here this year. Put that in your mind. Now you have the ability. You have your health. You have your money. Provided, like we said, from the door of there, from Allah Azza wa Jal. So give him his right. As he obligated that upon us, we have to perform that, if we can. So may Allah Azza wa Jal accept us and make us one of those who follow the order from Allah Azza wa Jal, who fear him so much, so they stay away from all sins. And they love him so much, so they do everything that Allah Azza wa Jal ordered them to do. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت وتولنا يا ربنا في من توليت وبارك اللهم لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت اللهم قنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما واجعل تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين اللهم أعلي بفضلك كلمة الحق والدين اللهم اهزم أعداءك أعداءنا أعداء الدين اللهم اجعل بلادنا وبلاد المسلمين آمنة رخاء يا أرحم الراحمين برحمتك وبكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم ولي علينا خيارنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم ولي علينا من يصلح ومن يصلح يا رب العباد اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا أجمعين اللهم ارحمنا وارحم أمواتنا وأموات المسلمين اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم اصلحنا واصلح أحيانا والمسلمين اللهم ارحم والدينا كما ربيانا صغارا يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم اغفر وارحم وتجاوز عما تعلم إنك أنت العز الأكرم وأقم الصلاة